So today I thought I'd show you my Hoya collection. I'm getting into Hoyas right now because they are just bursting with growth and I'm obsessed right now. So I thought I'd show you guys my collection and comment what Hoya is your favorite. What Hoyas are you looking for right now? I actually really want to know because I might be having to put some things on my wish list. So let's just hop into the video. And I'm thinking I'm gonna do this in a houseplant tour type style. So starting it off is first my Hoya multiflora. It is pretty tall. I got this as one stem originally, but I cut it into two. And it is on the verge of blooming right now and has new growth. I did have this in a much darker corner, and I felt that it didn't like it. So I moved it to the window and now it is bursting with growth, as you can see. Excuse the mess, I'm sorry. But next up is what is on my shelf, on the top of my shelf right now. And this is Hoya retusa. On that shelf, I have a Hoya curtisii. And also you're gonna see a couple of saucers laying around because I did just bring a lot of plants outside. So, but this is my Hoya curtisii and it has put off a lot of new growth. Literally so much, but that is that one, and it is in Lekka and it is loving it. I'm also gonna throw my Deschidia onantha in here. It's also called the apple leaf Deschidia, but it is also bursting with new growth. So that is that one. Moving over, this is my Hoya Hishtikliana. It is blooming twice. I think these blooms over here are done. But these are on its way to opening up. And I just put this one on a trellis, as you can see. And right beside it, I have my Deschidia, what is this one? Ovata? Yeah, Deschidia ovata from Steve's Leaves, and I just have it like just wrapped on itself. So yeah. The next Hoya I have is Hoya ruthi, and I just have it going up this thing and coming to a tip right here. The next Hoya I want to show you is my Hoya maniparensis. I actually cut this up into three parts, but one of them didn't root, so the third one isn't in here. But I mean, it's pretty chill. It's kind of sun stressed under these lights. I'm thinking about bringing it outside, but it does have a new growth right here. Super cute. And then moving down, I have my Hoya polyneura. I actually sold, ow, I just got pricked by a cactus. I actually sold my original big Hoya polyneura and traded pieces when I found out that I didn't leave any pieces for myself. So there's actually three pieces of Hoya polyneura in here. But I love this so much more. And then I got this like mermaid pot from Target last year. And moving over, I have my Hoya, Hoya carnosa queen, and it's putting off a whole bunch of new growth right now. So this one looks super beautiful. Now we're gonna move outside because that is where the majority of my Hoyas reside right now. It is July, the summer is coming down to an end. It doesn't really start getting like cooler until September here where I live. So they will be out there for a couple more months, but they are bursting with growth and I can't wait to show you. So
outside at my like potting bench, but there was a guy who was mowing his grass, of course, when I came outside. So I started looking at my plants, just waiting on him. And I was looking at this Hoya sergioensis, and looking at how much growth this thing has gotten. And these two leaves right here are gonna get even bigger because they're still like new feeling and they're still like on that like soft, they haven't hardened off yet. So these leaves are going to be huge and I'm super excited for this Hoya. All of these Hoyas, I was looking and there wasn't one that I couldn't find new growth on. So, yeah, I'm gonna start off at the top and move you across and then down. So starting it off, I have my Hoya, Carrie-Eye green, and this has so much new growth right there, and then right here, and then on the other side there's new leaves right there too. But I just cut off like a huge piece. It was like growing all the way up to the top to sell on a Hoya purge, but it had a peduncle on it. So that was kind of stupid, but I had already sold it by the time I figured out that it was going to flower. So that wasn't that smart. But then I also have this Hoya Mauna Loa I got from Casey's Green Thumb. We did a trade and I've also had this Hoya before. I had like a full pot, but I killed the whole thing over the winter. So that kind of hurts my soul every time I think about it. Moving on. I also have my Hoya Australis that I got in an unboxing some time ago, but it is also just booming with growth. Honestly, this Hoya like is the easiest grower ever, in my opinion, indoors and out, but I simply just love this one. And then this is my oldest Hoya right here, is my Hoya rubra that I got from Lowe's like 2.5 years ago. And it is also just thriving and loving outside. Next up is, I'm gonna get you from this angle. This is my Hoya Lenny Aris that I got in an unboxing a few months ago. It was sometime during the winter, but it is also loving it outside. I did have it in a good amount of light before this, but you know, it wasn't actually doing anything. And I think now it is perked up. I don't think I see like much new growth, but it looks better and the ends do have new growth on them. But yeah, this one, my Hoya Dakii, I won from Gabriella's Plants last year. It has grown, but just simply not this much. I was telling my mom the amount of growth that my Hoyas have right now outside versus inside is kind of offensive. I put in all this work and you barely grow, and then I stick you outside and fend for yourselves and all of a sudden you're bursting with growth. So that's kind of disheartening, but it's cool. it has two new growths right there. It is growing from the middle. Let me turn you around. Right here, right here, right here. Like, I'm like, oh my god, that little nubbin, can you see that? That little nubbin is growing right there, and it's just doing so much. I love this thing, and I can't wait for it to get absolutely huge. So there's that. And then this one was kind of offensive for me too, because I got this in a swap with one of my friends on Instagram. This is a Hoya Crinkle 8, and it did absolutely nothing for me inside up until this point. I put this out a month ago, and look at that. New growth. Look at that. Right there. New growth. I'm like, well, that's not fair though. That's not fair, but I mean, now you're growing, so I guess it's okay, but that kind of hurt my feelings. It's cool. It's cool. And then right here, I cut up my Hoya Comingiana and stuck it back into the pot. And I'm rerooting it because I want a big one. I want a big Comingiana. This piece right here is the original plant. And that is the only rooted part. So we'll see how that does outside. This right here is my Hoya Bilobata / Bertinet / D7D. I don't actually know what it's called thingy, but it loves it out here. And that's all she wrote. It has flowered nonstop for me this summer, and there basically hasn't been a time that it hasn't flowered for me. So this one is doing amazing. Don't mind the white. It's a little bit of a diatomaceous earth on it that, you know, the leaves are a little fuzzy, so I would have to take every leaf and wipe every leaf. So I just haven't done that yet. So, you know me, putting off things until I absolutely have to do it. So, next up is my Hoya Eskimo that I got from I can't remember, but I also did this in an unboxing a few months ago, and it's doing amazing. It's got some new growth right there. And I mean, this thing was like taking off inside. I didn't put it out here, honestly, until like a few days ago. So it's like freshly out here. But I can't wait to see what growth it has, the amount of growth it has while it's out here. So right beside it is my Hoya Carnosa, just green form one, and yeah, it's doing all right. That's my Sergioensis. This is my Rosea something that I got a few months ago, but it's doing so much better. When I first got it, didn't look that great, but it's putting out new growth that looks amazing. So there's that one. And then bringing you around here, I also did the same thing with my this is the cup one, starts with a B, something with a B. I'll put it across the screen. But I also cut up this one and stuck it back into the pot because I also want a bigger one. So that's that. This is the Hoya, variegated Hoya Carrii that I got from Asian Imports, and it is doing amazing. It put off this leaf with me and this baby leaf. And I absolutely love it. This is my Hoya Fungi. Maybe I found the only Hoya that isn't doing anything. I don't think it's doing anything. I can't find any like new growth or anything. But this one also kind of hates me, but it's cool. It's cool. It put off this leaf with me, and I thank you for that, but I'd like more. So that is Hoya Fungi. Fungi. And then I got this from Growing Green in North Carolina. And I'm pretty sure that this is Hoya echinosa, but I'm not actually sure. Don't quote me, but it has a lot of new growth as well. This is Hoya Matil that I got from a Hoya like purge a few months ago, and it has done nothing for me until it came outside, of course, and now it is just bursting with new growth and finally doesn't completely hate my whole life. And it came with these two I think one of them fell off, but this peduncle, it came with this peduncle. All right, and moving you back to the front, I have my Hoya Schroepperdii that is bursting with growth. I actually love this one. It was on my bottom shelf and could literally tell when it turned summer because it started doing things. So I appreciate that one for not being too shady to me. And then this is my Hoya macrophylla that hates my life always, but it's cool. It's put off these, I think, two leaves since summer, and then it put off those two leaves at the bottom. And moving around town, my other Hoya lacanosa that hates me a lot more than the other one. We're not gonna talk about that for long. And then this is my Hoya cinnaminifolia that I won from Tony, I forgot what it's called, The Tiny Jungle on Instagram. And I grew this humongous leaf. It's absolutely huge, as big as my hand. And at first when I got it, it had these two leaves, this one and this one, and it looked like a whole bunch of sticks in a pot. And then it started growing things, and those things became like leaves, and I got so excited. So this stick, can you see? Let's see if it can focus. Okay, this stick grew these two leaves right there, and then there's a stick in the back that hasn't done anything, but it's gonna do something, it looks like. So it's right there, and it looks like it's gonna do something. But then at the top, it put off all of these long tendrils, and like that big leaf sprouted and is gonna put off this leaf. And this leaf, and then it's like just going to the back. Bye. And yeah, so that is all the Hoyas, I think, on this bench. And then we're gonna move over here. I have some Hoyas just sitting on the this like chair, and this is the Hoya that Nicole gave me. It's got some new growth, but I accidentally put it in the sun and it burned a little bit, so I'm sorry. Hopefully it forgives me and puts out a lot of growth. So that's my Hoya pubicalyx purple. Then my struggling Hindu rope that hates my life because I gave up on it, like, I don't know, sometime in March, because it got mealybugs, and I just gave up and started throwing it everywhere. So there's that. Next up is some fun stuff. Hoyas in the tree. So first, can I say that I had the idea to put Hoyas in a tree because if you look up where Hoyas live in the wild, it's in the trees. So I thought that would be the best like thing for them during the summer. So That's why I have all of my hanging Hoyas, all of the ones that like have hanging hooks, because I didn't have enough to hang everything in trees. So I have my variegated Weyetii in a tree, and that's how it looks. And it's got some green in there, but you know, I'm trying to grow it out. This is my green Hoya Weyetii, and it is absolutely just bursting with new growth. Hopefully you guys can see that. Next up, my Hoya Publicalyx Pink, and it is also putting off a lot of new growth. There's some right there, there, and like just humongous leaves. Like the leaves are like longer than my finger, and it's just absolutely beautiful. I didn't think I would like this plant. This is another plant that I won from Gabriella's Plants, but I didn't think I would like it that much, to be honest. And I absolutely love this plant. It came in a 4-inch pot and is now growing out of a 6-inch pot. I'll even take it down just to show you like how much growth it actually has, and it's growing out of the top too. So that's that one. Love that. This is now my Hoya Chelsea that I got last summer of 2019, and I've literally done so many, like I'm talking over 20 cuttings with like, and like long pieces too. So I've cut, sold, traded so many pieces of this plant. So I absolutely love this plant, and of course it is also bursting with growth. It's got this long 2 tendrils down here, and this has to be one of my favorite Hoyas in my collection. I just like, can we just talk about it? It's amazing. And these leaves are actually kind of huge, like if you want to compare them. Like this is a regular leaf, and this is like the huge leaf that it grew. So I don't know, it's huge. I love it. Next up is another big boy. This is my Hoya Obovata. I'm gonna also take this down. This is my Hoya Obovata, and it is in an 8-inch pot, and it is growing so big. It's absolutely huge and heavy. So that is that plant. I love this one, so big. And then I also have my Hoya Neo Ebudica that I also put in a hanging pot recently, and it is loving it outside. So I also cut up some pieces and put it in here, so it's actually propagating. That's probably why you see like a yellow leaf right there. But I love it. It looks divine in this tree. So yeah, I think that is all of my Hoyas, at least the ones that I can see and find. So I'll just give you a quick little pan. So yeah, the bugs are biting me. Yeah, that was all of my Hoyas that I have in my collection. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And tell me which one is your favorite. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I hope you guys